You know, a lot of digging is underway tonight along the riverfront west of the suspension bridge. That's where the city's new park will go.
But it is still 3 years away from completion. On the other side of the bridge is where you find News 5's John London tonight with a look at what will open up in the months ahead.
Well, there's a lot of cool construction going on down here east of the suspension bridge that will come at you quickly this year. One is a labyrinth being built right behind me here for your riverfront solitude. You'll want a space to contemplate with all this activity going on. They're rolling at top speed right now to finish the Moorline Logger House within the next few weeks. This is a peek at the inside where you can hoist a cold one and let your eyes wander the new beauty of a river city. This is what the labyrinth will look like. Don't call it a maze. It's meant to center, not confuse you. They will soon plant 200 trees down here. Here's the image. And you might want to plant yourself at the Walnut Street Fountain this summer.
We want this to be our Spanish Steps.
Here is what the finished product will look like. Cascading water on each side, visually and physically connecting the urban core to the city's waterway.
We want to celebrate downtown meeting the river.
The Schmidlap event lawn is nearing completion on the walkways and granite. A stage canopy with solar panels will be up by March. The Black Brigade Memorial and a 1,000-foot-long boat dock are in the plans. As a lot of earth is moved down here this winter, we can't help but contemplate the cobweb of federal grant bureaucracy still to untangle.
The labyrinth is a federal maze right now?
It is. Yeah, I've got to allow the word maze in that case, but we are negotiating our way through that.
But the beauty of what's to come with the Women's Garden and the rest is self-evident. So mark your new calendar. February 27th, the Moorline Logger House. April, the Bike Center. May 18th, the Walnut Street Steps and Fountain. Along the new riverfront, John London, News 5.